closing ceremony this evening. We've had a wonderful week full of various events, ranging from photography, video editing, to disc jockeying, and even trading on the stock markets. I joined the Lamartine Extracurricular Organization, or as Leo we call it, in class 7. Since then, I've played various roles in the organization, from having my own inter-school events to being a participant in this very event, and now serving as your student coordinator, along with Amrita. From having more than 45 events in the physical edition of Constantia, down to 13 due to the constraints of the pandemic, from having more than 1,200 participants on campus, and now having an interaction using a virtual setup, from closing ceremonies such as this one, echoing with participants cheering for their respective teams, to now us interacting through this camera, I'll say that Constantia has had to endure its fair share of changes during the pandemic. But even though we missed the physical editions of this event, I'm very proud to say that the team put in its best effort to put together this event and make it a success. Everyone kept the Martinian spirit of wanting to be perfect, even in the face of challenges, so that we can be boastful about it later. All in the entire event, the entire team made a lot of memories throughout the preparation of the event, be it bickering within Charles and Harshit to get the sponsorship money and fix our expenditures, be it asking Raven to check all our speeches and brochures for grammatical errors, be it calling Divyam and Raghav in the middle of the night and asking for the registration forms, be it Omar and Abhimanyu helping us with the logisticals, and most importantly, Danish helping us with all the technicalities, be it the registration forms, be it the forms that have to be submitted, be it the judging sheets. And Danish plays an imperative role in our team. Most of what you saw today, we inherited from our seniors, from Garvit Kalra and Karthikey teaching us what it means to be professional, from Soham and Sanskar teaching us how to handle logistics, and from Anand Raza and Pratham teaching us how to deal with hospitality. We've learned a great deal from our seniors, and whatever you found in the last week of events to be very smart and efficient, we've got to credit our seniors for that, because they've taught us an immense deal, and I'd like to take this opportunity to thank each and every one of them. Now to introduce the very capable organizing committee of my juniors. The boys, they helped us a lot. They helped us making teasers, they helped us with our duties, they've helped us with the judging sheets, and each and every logistical aspect of the event, without even complaining. They've worked throughout midnight, they've burned the midnight oil, and I've worked tirelessly to bring this event together, and I believe they deserve some recognition at this point. I now request the principal to receive each and every one of them. Now the organizing committee members in no particular order are Urt Singh, followed by Siddharth Mishra, Parv Johar, Mohammad Ibad Hussain, Ehsan Ahmed, Ronit Singh, Varnit Pandey, Parth Agnihotri, Ansh Shivastav, followed by Vansh Shivastav, Dhruv Deobhalla, Sparsh Jaiswal, Man Habib, Divyansh Kapoor, Rudranch Pandey. I would like to thank all the organizing committee members for putting in the hard work to bring this event together. I would like to thank the principal for receiving each of them. Now I would like to present to you a short film by the Lamartineau Creative Arts Society on the topic of mental health of a student. The Lamartineau Creative Arts Society participates in a number of cultural activities throughout the year and prepare a certain amount of skits for certain events. And they've most recently prepared a short film on this topic, and it will be presented in the closing ceremony, as it is relevant to all of us.
So Ria, your results were due this week. I guess you did great, as always.
Yes, Papa. I got an A+, as usual.
Thank you.
Akash, how much marks did you get? How much marks? All of our investments on your academics are completely waste. Akash! No, Akash! मैं बता रहा हूं उसका कुछ नहीं हो सकता. He has been spoiled by our pampering. All of our investments on your academics are completely waste. मैं बता रहा हूं उसका कुछ नहीं हो सकता. He has been spoiled by our pampering.
Hey, freak show.
What happened? Is there something that's bothering you?
Wait a minute. I know.
Daddy issues.
Not that it's any of your concern. But I'm having problems at home.
With your dad, right? You know what? You should tell your dad that you and your sister are different. You should confront him.
No need to say anything. This happens everywhere. Chill.
Bro, you know there is more than one way to cope up with your pain, right?
And what's that?
You both know, right? You both know.
But you have started stealing too?
Dad, I'm sorry, please, Dad.
Mom?
Yes?
Can I talk to you for a moment?
Sure. What happened?
It's about something serious regarding Akash.
Sit. Tell me.
The incident that happened today was not supposed to take place.
Akash was influenced by his friends to do such things. If he really wanted to do it,
He could have done it with no problem and we wouldn't have even known. But he didn't do it because his conscience didn't allow him to do such a thing.
These are all excuses. You know that? He doesn't listen to his parents. He lays around in his bed all day long watching TV. And he doesn't even pay attention in his studies. Don't you see? He's a spoiled child. And you? You're a bright man. Stop always taking his side.
I think he really needs serious professional help. It seems that he's suffering from depression. And it's quite clear from his actions that he does not do on a daily purpose. What kind of help? It's expensive and it's a waste of time. Don't you see? He's just a spoiled child.
Just give the thought, Mom. Okay, if you say so, I'll think about it.
Dad, I've been meaning to talk to you about something since a while now.
Here we go again. Now what happened, Akash?
The environment in my school is very bad, Dad. I've been getting bullied by my seniors. I can't even concentrate on my studies. It's affecting my mental health.
You both go to the same school, Akash, and look at how she has turned out. You are a boy, Akash. Try to deal with your own problems and don't cry about them. This generation, I tell you.
Ma? Please don't scold him now. It's enough for today.
Hey, how's Akshita?
She's good. Hey, look at that guy.
Hey, you moron, come up here. Hey, what are you looking at? Get him up here.
Hey, you swine, where are you going? Are you deaf or what?
Stop! Stop, leave me! Leave me! What the?
Hey, kneel down, kar.
But what did I do?
Kneel down, kar.
What did I do?
Kneel down, kar. When I tell you to do something, you do it.
Oi, button de kiska?
Take off his clothes. What? What?
Get up.
What are you doing? Leave me. Leave me. Help. Someone help. Help me. Help me. Take off his clothes. What? What? What are you doing? Leave me. Leave me. Help. Someone help. Help me. Help me. You both go to the same school, Akash, and look at how she has turned out. You are a boy, Akash. Try to deal with your own problems and don't cry about them. This generation, I tell you.
I am the father of Akash. I was very ignorant to all his problems. I did not support him at any point. When he opened up to me for all his problems that he was not having a safe environment at school, I still scolded him. Today, for all those actions, I feel as a parent. Moreover, I feel as a human being. What could I have done is to support him, is to console him. And if I would have done all those things, my child would be alive having dinner with me right now. I should have supported him. I should have consoled him. I should have never compared my two children. It's all my fault. I lost my child.
When Akash's sister came to see her mother, asking her to help him, she very conveniently avoided the situation by regarding his behavior as excuses for not performing well and lazing around all day. As a mother, she loved both her children equally, but she failed to understand that both of them cannot be equally good at everything they do. Akash wasn't behaving that way because he was weak or lazy. He acted like that because of the way he was treated at school. And when his mother was aware of that, she tried to sympathize with him. But it was too late. He is no more now. And that guilt of not helping him when he needed his mother the most will always remain in our heart.
Akash came to see her sister, asking her to help him because his grades dropped and he found it really difficult for him to concentrate on his studies. He felt sad and irritable most of the days due to strict parenting and the unhealthy environment that he faced in his school. His sister conveyed his brother's situation to their mother, but her points were not taken seriously by her at that time. Maybe she could have tried to convince her mother even more by telling her that depression is a disease that can be cured by appropriate medication for which you have to see a doctor. She knew everything about his mental state and even took actions, but still, it wasn't enough to save him.
Did you know that one in every four students in India suffer from depression? Yet, we keep pretending that mental health problems are a hoax. Just like Akash, there are many other students who face similar problems, especially during their adolescent years, when mood swings tend to become more frequent. While it is quite obvious that every parent wants the best for their child, constantly scolding them, reprimanding them, and comparing them with others is not the right way to deal with them. They may feel that they are doing it for their child's benefit, but they fail to understand that a child needs their support even more when he is at an emotionally vulnerable stage. It's also a fact that a child learns more when he is appreciated for something he's good at than being scolded for something he's bad at. Only if Akash's family had listened to his struggles earlier, he would still be with us today.
Now we'll be presenting a short clip of the glimpses of the Lamartya campus and the events that took place in the Constantia this year. That a number of eminent people accepted our invitation to interact with the participants this year. And now we'd like to show you a clip of the same.
Hi everyone, and a very warm welcome to Shipwrecked. I know this is the 9th edition of the Constantia where this is taking place. I'm delighted that you all are exploring your creative side. You're exploring the side of you that delves in extracurriculars.
Mr. Carlisle McFarland, Principal Lamartine College. Mrs. Sheba Siddiqui, Mr. Hitesh Keswani, all participating students, teachers, parents who are attending this event, it is indeed a privilege to be among all of you. Ideally, we should have been together face to face, but in view of the pandemic, we still continue to be on a semi virtual world, but fingers crossed and seeing things the way they are, I'm sure the world and all of us will be back to normal.
Dear students, I am Sonia Khan from the Associated Board of the Royal Schools of Music, and I am delighted to be virtually present for the Constantia's 9th edition of the War of DJs. It is of great interest to see how Lamartine College is giving special emphasis on the co-curricular activities. And definitely the credit goes to your dynamic principal and his team for encouraging you to take more interest in activities like music, art, and photography.
Principal Mr. Kalai McFarland, Mrs. Siddiqui, the coordinator of this event, and the lovely students of Lamartine College. It's always a pleasure to be amongst students and the staff of the school. And for the first time, I'm joining in one of our events. And this in particular is closer to my heart because this happens to be an event associated more with my profession, journalism.
What I would like to share is that maths and physics will develop you theoretically, but the co-curricular activities will develop your personality. Therefore, music and the fine arts are as important as your mainstream subjects. For the mainstream subjects, you use your brains. But for music and the fine arts, you need your hearts.
Let me start by saying, learn not just to handle success, but failures as well. It is important you learn to manage failures, because any task or project that you do, you will come across problems, but these problems should not decide what you can do and, more importantly, what you cannot do. Always keep your mind open to new learnings. Learnings stimulate creativity, which in turn leads to thinking. Thinking opens your eyes to knowledge, and it is this knowledge that makes you truly great.
At La Martinia, we were always told that to be well-rounded people, we needed to do everything. Education, sports, extracurriculars, be conscious citizens. All of these things were things that were instilled into us. I managed to take the sports part very lightly and the extracurriculars part very, very seriously. And look at where I am today. I mean, 30 plus years later, I have a media company, a digital agency. I've directed a film, I've done radio, I've done television, theatre. Today, I run things on Spotify, I do podcasts. I still haven't got a YouTube channel or a TikTok, but who knows, maybe in the future, even that might be a possibility. But I'm a product today of what we call the creator economy. And it only happened because I focused on creativity while I was in school.
Let me tell you that this is a profession, the journalism profession, which is most unlike any other profession. Because, first of all, this is one thing where freshness is there. Whatever you do today, the next day it is yesterday. And that's the news is always fresh. That is what keeps you alive in this profession. There's no monotony. Because what is gone is over. Yesterday's news is no news.
So go on. Take up one of these fine arts and live your dreams to the fullest.
The end all is to do something meaningful, do something which is a serious contribution.
Have fun, enjoy yourself, and once again, thank you, La Martinia, for giving me this opportunity.
My best wishes to all the participants. My congratulations in advance to all the winners. But once again, I would like to say, it is opportunities like this, platforms like this, that give you the openings and windows to so many new possibilities in the world. And we all must be extremely grateful to institutions like the La Martinia College and to each of our institutions who bring us and enable us to come onto such platforms of learning and growth. My best wishes to all of you.
Now I'd like to introduce the co-curricular activities coordinator of La Martinia College, Mrs. Shreba Siddiqui. Mrs. Siddiqui has been a constant support to all the LEO members and has been a backbone of the entire events that have been organized by us. She supported us throughout and has taken our suggestions at every step, making this experience more meaningful and a learning event for all of us. Now I'd like to invite her to give a few words.
Once a great man whispered, "Feeling thankfulness and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it." Today, I take the opportunity to put all my gratitude into words. To begin with, I would like to express my gratitude to Mr. Carlisle McFarland, who besides being a visionary, is the most supportive and understanding principal an institution can ever have. 8 years back, my predecessor, Mrs. Rachna Tandon, and Mr. McFarland conceptualized this event, and since then, it has grown from strength to strength. From a one-day local event, it has now become a four-day international event. I thank each one of you who have participated in Constantia 2021. An event of this magnitude is not possible without teamwork. I thank my vice principal for always being there for any kind of help that's needed. From reprimanding the boys from time to time when needed, to scrutinizing and signing all the score sheets of the various events. I extend my gratitude to all my colleagues
who have worked tirelessly behind the scenes as teachers in charge for the various events, those who have been instrumental in getting the certificates and results ready on time, and the media team of the college for the amazing work they have done in getting the recordings done. A special thanks to the EDP department for all the technical help and support. Without them, I would have been totally lost. On behalf of the school and all the students, I would like to thank our guest speakers who took out time from their busy schedule and sent us their recorded videos. Your words have indeed inspired the students. I would be failing in my duty if I didn't thank my sponsors. They are Mo by DNM, Bindals, Career Guru, United We Care, and SigTough. Last but not the least, my Leo team, my boys. I am at a loss of words of how to thank them. I can only say that I am here because of them. It would be difficult for me to name a few because each of them works very hard in their own capacity. They are the backbone not only of Constantia, but of so many other events organized by the college. So thank you, boys, for everything. Thank you once again to each one of you. Stay safe till we meet again next year, hopefully physically at our home, Lamartnia. Vive Lamartnia.
Thank you to Mrs. Sheba Siddiqui for those words of wisdom. Now to call upon our principal, Mr. Carlisle McFarlane, who has been a constant support for the entire Leo team. He's taken up the silliest of suggestions that we've asked him. He's given us all the resources that he could and has been a support and a constant guide throughout the event, throughout the preparation of the event, ongoing of the event, and in the ceremonies. And I cannot express my thanks to him in words. So now I would like to call him up for his vote of thanks.
A very good evening to all the participants at Constantia 2021 who have tuned in to this streaming of the closing ceremony for this event. This is indeed our flagship event every year. The entire year goes in preparation. As Saksham said a little while ago, we generally have 40 plus events over this sprawling campus, and classes continue even while the programs are on. This is because of the meticulous preparation that goes into the planning of this event months and months in advance. Why do I mention this to you this evening? Because it is a part of the entire planning for Lamartnia training its boys. Day by day, more and more experience is gained by them. We might have many, many participants from different parts of the country, but we have a dedicated team of boys that function with a certain pecking order and learn skills which they will use in later life. A little while ago, I was happy to greet each one of the boys in uniform who next year, I know, will be organizing this event almost independently. I am so happy to share the stage this evening with the smartest boys of my college, dressed so correctly, who are now ready to move into the world, taking with them the experience that they have gained from events such as this. My colleague, Mrs. Sheba Siddiqui, has thanked the various people who have worked behind the scenes, including those who were invitees for this program, guest speakers included. The judges have had to adapt to the new system of judging online. And people of eminence, such as they have adapted to the requirements of the internet age with alacrity. I am grateful to all the members of staff who have also put together these events along with the boys. But this evening is for the participants who have won prizes. They have displayed merit, and be absolutely sure, from whichever part of the country you may be, if you are a prize winner at Constantia 2021, you have been judged by the most eminent of people from different parts of the country in a manner that is absolutely transparent and which also has complete sanctity. I congratulate you. For those who have participated, we are fortunate to have this media to be able to share some of those products with you. The artwork which you have done, the music which you have created, the theater which you have taken part in, these are all things which are now available for all to see, which would not have been available a few years ago. I am grateful to principals of institutions who have permitted their pupils to join in this event. I do hope that my boys will also put up the best of shows when they take part in the different programs that you organize and which we are certain to attend as well. Once again, many thanks to each of you for participating, to all those who have organized this under the direction of Amritam Gupta and Saksham Tiwari, the very capable coordinators of Constantia 2021. Along with their team of the very smart men in black who are seated on my right, I bring a close to this event as well as to this ceremony, wishing you all the very best.
I would like to thank the principal for that speech. And now moving on to the most awaited moment of the entire ceremony, the results. The results will be showcased to you via a slideshow presentation that will be up on your screens now. congratulate all the winners of Constantia 2021 and would like to thank all the participants for joining in and making the event special. Now we hope to see you again next year, hopefully on campus. And with that, I bring this closing ceremony to an end. Thank you and vive la Martinique.